Hello friends, good morning. In my previous lecture, I had explained unrestricted earthfall protection of the generator, restricted earthfall protection of the generator, as well as 100% earthfall protection of the generator. So today I will discuss few numericals on restricted earthfall protection of the generator. For restricted earthfall protection of the generator, we have derived one equation, that is percentage of winding unprotected. This is the percentage of winding unprotected, x is the winding protected. So if you multiply this by 100, it will be percentage of the winding unprotected is equal to R, that is neutral grounding resistance, into I pickup, that is the pickup of the relay from this primary side of the CT, divided by voltage. This should be phase voltage of the generator multiplied by 100. First numerical is, a generator is provided with restricted earthfall protection. Generator ratings are 11 kV, 5 MVA. The scheme protects 80% of the winding. Relay setting is such that it trips for 25% out of balance current. 25% out of balance current means 25% of the rated current. Compute the resistance inserted in the neutral grounding circuit. So this is the formula to be used. So first compute the voltage V, phase value. 11 kV is the line value, so 11 divided by root 3. If we multiply this by 1000, we get result in volts. So it is 6356 volts. This is 6350 volts. Current, we have formula for the power, root 3 into V into I is equal to power. So 5 MVA. I am converting this into kVA, so 5 into 1000. Divided by root 3 into 11 kV. This is in kVA, this is also in kV. So current is coming in amperes. It is 262 amperes. Pickup of the relay is 25% of the rated current. That is 25% out of balance current. Means 25% of this I. So it is coming 65.5 ampere. So percentage of winding unprotected is R into I pickup divided by V into 100. Now percentage of winding protected is 80%, so 1 minus x in percentage will be 20, that is 20% is unprotected, is R into 65.5, that is pickup, divided by voltage, that is 6350 into 100. So resistance inserted is 19.28 ohms, that is the answer. Second question or second numerical, neutral point of 10 kV alternator is earthed through a resistance of 10 ohms. The relay pickup is 1 ampere. Now here you can see it is from the relay side. Because it is just 1 ampere, means it is from the relay side. CTs have a ratio of 1000 by 5. So in order to get the current from the primary side, that is generator side, CT ratio is given. First part is, what percentage of winding will be protected against earth fault? Second is, compute the resistance required for protecting 90% winding against earth fault. So this is the formula. Percentage of winding unprotected is equal to R into pickup divided by V into 100. Pickup is 1 ampere from the relay side. So from primary side, it will be 1 into CT ratio, that is 1000 by 5. So it is coming 200 ampere. 1 minus X is the percentage of winding unprotected. So it is R, that is 10, that is given in the numerical, 10 ohms. Multiplied by pickup, that we have computed 200 ohms, 200 amperes, divided by voltage. It is 10 kV generator, 10 kV is line value, so 10 divided by root 3 into 1000, so that will give in volts multiplied by 100. So it is coming 38.8%. So this much percentage of the winding is unprotected. The percentage of winding protected will be 100 minus 34.8, that is 65.2%. So 65.2% will be the percentage of winding protected. Second part is, compute the resistance required for protecting 90% winding against earth fault. So we have to increase the percentage of winding protected from 65.2 to 90%. So X is 90%. So 1 minus X will be 10%. That is equal to R. R will change. I pickup will remain same, that is 200. Divided by voltage, that is 10,000 divided by root 3 multiplied by 100, So R is coming 2.88 ohms. So here you can see, if we reduce the value of resistance, the percentage of winding protected will increase. In first case, resistance is 10 ohms, so winding protected is 65.2%. Second case, resistance has drastically reduced, it has reduced to 2.88 ohms, so winding protected is 90%. Third numerical, this is very good numerical. In a percentage differential protection scheme of an alternator, the relay has slope of 10%. A high resistance earth fault occurs near the grounded neutral end. As a consequence, the current in amperes flowing at each end are 304 amperes and 320 amperes respectively. Assuming CT ratio of 400/5, answer the following questions. Number 1. Will the relay trip the breaker? Second, if the generator circuit breaker is open, will the relay operate? And third, show the relay characteristic and the points that represent operating and standing current in above conditions. So first I will explain this with the diagram. So this is the diagram. Let us say this is the winding of one phase where fault has taken place. This point must be grounded through resistance. So fault is taking place near the neutral point of the generator. So this is the fault, or we can say it is the high impedance earth fault, because this resistance which is shown here during neutral grounding will automatically come in this circuit. So here fault is shown through this resistance. Here resistance value is not given, so we have to use the different equations, that is equations for the differential relay. Current coming from this side of the generator is 320 amperes. Current going from this side is 304 ampere. So one set of CT will be here, one set of CT will be here, and relay will be connected in the differential circuit. The relay will consist of the standing coil as well as operating coil. This is circuit breaker, and this part will be connected to the load. So let us say this is I1, 320 amperes. This is I2, 304 amperes. So I1, 320 amperes, I2, 304 amperes. So these are the currents from the primary side of the CT. Now CT ratio is given, it is 400/5. So let us compute the current on the secondary side. So for I2, it is coming 3.8 ampere. For I1, 320 divided by CT ratio, so it is coming 4 ampere. So I1 is 4 amperes, I2 is 3.8 amperes. Now for percentage differential delay, that is in the multiplier protection scheme, the operating condition is I1 minus I2, that is the differential current, should be greater than B times I1 plus I2 by 2, this is mean circulating current, and B is the bias, that is slope of the characteristic. The bias, that is slope of the characteristic is given 10%, 10% means 0.1. So let us solve the first part. Will the relay trip the breaker? We have computed I2 and I1. B is given, so let us check the operating condition. So I1 minus I2 is coming 4 minus 3.8, that is 0.2 amperes. I1 plus I2 is 4 plus 3.8 divided by 2, that is 3.9 amperes. Slope of the characteristic is given 10%, that is 0.1. So let us compute this right hand side of this equation. B I1 plus I2 by 2, it is coming 0.39. Left hand side, I1 minus I2. It is coming I1 minus I2 is coming 4 minus 3.8, that is 0.2 amperes. So this operating condition is not satisfied, because this is 0.2 and this is 0.39. So this right hand side is greater than left hand side. So operating condition is not satisfied, therefore the relay will not trip. So you can see here, as the fault is involving some resistance, secondly, it is near to the neutral point of the generator, the relay has failed to detect the fault. It is not operating. Now let us come to the second part of the problem. If the generator circuit breaker is open, will the relay operate? Now here, if this generator circuit breaker is open, this I2 will become 0. I2 will become 0. Only I1 will remain there. And in this part, less EMF will be generated. Therefore, less current is flowing through this. So here we have to consider I1 is equal to 320 amperes. I2 is 0, and these are the currents from the primary side of the relay. So here second part is, if circuit breaker is already open, I2 is 0, I1 from secondary side of the CT, that is current flowing actually through the relay, is 4 amperes. So I1 minus I2 is 4, because I2 is 0. I1 plus I2 by 2 will be 4 plus 0 divided by 2, that is 2, multiplied by B, that is 0.1. So it is 0.2 amperes. So it is coming 4 amperes. It is 4 amperes, and this is 0.2. So condition is satisfied. Therefore, the relay will trip. Third part is, show the relay characteristic and the point that represents operating and distancing current in above condition. So we have to draw the relay characteristic. For percentage differential relay, we take mean circulating current, that is I1 plus I2 by 2 along x-axis, and differential current, that is I1 minus I2 along y-axis. We have to take similar scales on both the sides. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4, approximately this is 1, 2, 3 and 4. Slope is given 10%. So for 10% slope, this is the line. If you are plotting this in the graph paper, then you can take the tan inverse of 0.1. You'll be getting, it is approximately 5 degrees. So you can draw a line at 5 degree angle with respect to this axis. So below this, it is restraining region. Above this, it is operating region. Now let us find out where P1 point and P2 point lies. P1 point is point corresponds to first condition, and P2 point corresponds to second condition. So P1 will be 3.9, 0.2, that is 3.9, 0.2. So it is I1 plus I2 by 2, this is I1 minus I2. So this is the location, 3.9 approximately here, 0.2 approximately here. So it is P1, it is coming in the restraining region. And mathematically also we obtained that for this condition the relay is not operating. Now point P2, I1 minus I2 is 4, and I1 plus I2 by 2 will be 4 plus 0 divided by 2, that is 2. So let us locate the point. P2 is 2 and 4, so it is 2, it is 4. So P2, it is coming in the operating region. So relay will operate for this second condition. So this is the graphical representations of relay characteristic, as well as point P1 and P2 corresponding to first condition and second condition respectively. Next numerical, a star connected 3 phase 12 MVA 11 kV generator has a phase reactance of 10%. Phase reactance of 10% means the winding reactance of each phase winding is 10%, that is in per unit. 10% means 0.1 per unit. It is protected by MERS price protection scheme. The relay is said to operate for fault current of 200 amperes. Compute the neutral earthing resistance to ensure 85% of the winding protection. So we have same formula. Percentage of winding unprotected is R upon V into I pickup multiplied by 100. Here X is percentage of winding protected, that is 85%. So 1 minus X will be 15%. V, it is 11 kV generator, 11 kV is line voltage. So phase voltage will be 11,000 divided by root 3, that is phase voltage. Pickup is 200 ampere, that is already given from the generator side, that is primary side of the CT. Now here the difference is, here we are not neglecting the reactance of the generator winding, that is given 10%. So neutral bounding resistance coming in series with the winding impedance. So this R will be replaced by Z, which will consist of neutral grounding resistance plus reactance of the winding. R is neutral grounding resistance and X is winding reactance. Now it is given in percentage, that is per unit. It is 0.1 per unit. So we need the reactance in ohmic value. So we have formula, per unit reactance is equal to actual reactance divided by base reactance. Base reactance or base impedance is given by this formula, kV base square divided by MVA base. kV is given 11 kV. So 11 kV square divided by base MVA, that is 12. that is own basis, own values of the generator. So it is coming 10.083. So this is base value. So actual value will be x per unit multiplied by x base. X per unit is 0.1, so 0.1 multiplied by 10.083. So actual value is coming 1.0083 ohms. Now this is the total impedance of the winding, total reactance of the winding. Now percentage of winding protected is 85%. So the 15% which is from the neutral end will not be protected. So we have to consider only impedance of reactance or reactance of 15% of the winding. So 1.0083 is the reactance of complete winding. So when we consider 15%, we have to take 15% of this value. So it is coming 0.15 ohms. So use same formula, 1 minus x percentage. So 15% of the winding is unprotected. So here we are replacing R by Z, which will consist of R square plus X square divided by V, 11 kV. So 11,000 divided by root 3 into pickup, that is 200 multiplied by 100. So Z is coming 4.7631 ohms. This consists of resistance plus reactance of the winding. Reactance of the winding is 0.15 ohms. So it is 4.76, that is equal to square root of R square plus 0.15 square. So R comes out 4.65 ohms. Resistance connected in the neutral grounding circuit is 4.65 ohms with reactance of 0.15 ohms of the winding. We are providing protection to 85% of the winding. Friends, if you feel this video lecture useful, then please like it, subscribe to my channel, ask your friends, colleagues and juniors to subscribe to my channel for upcoming video lectures on power system protection and high voltage engineering. If you want to make effective and efficient use of your time, then read my book on time management. The link for the book is given here as well as in the description box. I have launched a useful course for the students on Udemy. The title of the course is Accelerate Your Learning by Power of Visualization. This course is specifically useful for the students who are preparing for entrance and competitive exam. This is the link for the book. It is also given in the description box.